The You're To There podcast, it's time to start the show. Be sure to hold on tight, here we go. Exploring all the different Disney destinations. You're To There, it's time to start the fun.
Hey everybody, and welcome to the You're To There podcast, Walt Disney World Word of the Week. This is a brand new complimentary podcast to my already extremely popular and famous Ear to There podcast. So each week I'm going to come to you with a new Walt Disney World word and then give you some tips, tricks, hints, information, all kinds of fun stuff about that word. This week's word of the week is brought to you by the letter A. A for Ariel. Of course, A is for Ariel. If you don't know, Ariel is the main character in Disney's 1989 classic, The Little Mermaid, which was Disney's 28th animated feature, actually. The movie is often considered the beginning of Disney's new golden age of animation, which included other classics like Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, The Lion King, you know, all those kinds of movies. All right, so back to Ariel, and more specifically, where you can find Ariel in Walt Disney World. The good news is she's not very hard to find at all. You can pretty much find her all over the place in Walt Disney World. So let's start with Disney's Hollywood Studios. So at the studios, you can find Ariel in the Voyage of the Little Mermaid show. This is a 20-plus minute show that stars Ariel. She actually sings live, which is really, really cool. It's an attraction that little kids will love, adults will love. It's been there since the park opened, which is, you know, so if you haven't had a chance to see it, go see it. It's a very cool show. You can get fast passes for this one. It is a fast passable, if that's a phrase, fast passable. We're going to go with it. If you can get fast passes for it, but it's not really recommended that you get fast passes for this one. I would instead maybe get fast passes for, you know, one of the headliners, Tower of Terror, Toy Story Midway Mania, Star Tours, Rock and Roller Coaster, those kinds of things. All right, so that's the only place you're going to find Ariel over at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Now let's take a look at Epcot. So at Epcot, you're going to find Ariel in the Norway Pavilion in Epcot's World Showcase. And not all the time, most of the time, I can say. I can't say all the time, just in case. But Ariel's going to be found at the Akershus Royal Banquet Hall. That is the restaurant, in the full-service restaurant in the Norway Pavilion. And this is a character meal, so you're going to get the chance to eat with Ariel. Well, she's not going to sit down and eat with you. I mean, I guess you could, technically, but I'm not going to put my money on it. Anyway, you can also see Snow White there. You can see Aurora there. The princesses rotate sometimes, but like I said, most of the time, you will find Ariel there. The thing about this experience is it is an extremely difficult reservation to get. I mean, one of the hardest ones to get on property. So I'd recommend when your dining reservations open up, which is 180 days before your trip starts, you need to be online booking that reservation. Or shameless plug, you can book with a Disney specialized travel agent like myself who will do that booking for you so you don't have to worry about it. And that's going to do it for Epcot. You're going to meet Ariel at Akershus, and that's pretty much it. Now, you're probably saying to yourself, hey, Phil, guess what? You only named a couple of places. I'm starting to get nervous. There's not many places to meet Ariel. You said there were. Hey, guess what? We didn't talk about Magic Kingdom yet. At Magic Kingdom, there are three, yes, three places to see Ariel. The first one is going to be in the Festival of Fantasy Parade. Now, the Festival of Fantasy Parade is daily, and it starts at 3 p.m. Well, it starts at 3 p.m. This is the thing. This is the famous, what time does the 3 o'clock parade start? Technically, yeah, the parade starts at 3 p.m., but it starts in Frontierland. So it goes through a little bit of Frontierland first, then it gets out to the hub in front of Cinderella Castle. Then it comes down Main Street, makes a little circle around Town Square there, and exits stage left near the firehouse. So depending on where you're standing, the Festival of Fantasy Parade is going to go by anywhere from 3 p.m. till 3:30. So you're going to get a chance to see Ariel in this parade. Just Remember, it's not always going to be at 3 o'clock, depending on where you are. Now, that's the first place in Magic Kingdom. The second place where you can find Ariel in Magic Kingdom is actually at her own grotto. The grotto is in New Fantasyland, so you can meet her there. It's a really cool meet and greet. You get a couple of minutes. She'll sign autographs. She'll take pictures. You can record video. They also have the Disney Photo Pass people there, so they'll take pictures of you or your kids. They'll save them right to your Magic Band. It's really great. So yeah, I'd recommend doing that one. And I'd also recommend getting fast passes for this one if it's something that you and your kids absolutely must do and can't miss. Because the lines can get a little bit long there. And yeah, I would hate to see you miss out on an attraction because you didn't have a fast pass for it. Okay, the third place where you can find Ariel in Magic Kingdom is actually right next door to her grotto in her very own dark ride attraction called Under the Sea Journey of the Little Mermaid. But I do kind of have to put a disclaimer in here because this isn't the live version of Ariel. This is the audio animatronic version of Ariel on this attraction. But nonetheless, it's a great attraction. Imagineers really hit it out of the park with this one. It's actually even a fun queue to wait in. So if you don't have fast passes, the line is fun. It's interactive. There's these little crabs that are interactive in the queue. They make it a lot of fun to wait. It makes the time go by really quickly. But once again, if this is something that you look at and you say, hey, listen, I really, really want to do it, I'd recommend getting fast passes, as in the busier times of the year, the line can be, you know, up to an hour long. So it may be one that you want to get fast passes for. And yet another shameless plug for myself here, because let's face it, that's kind of what I do. If you're staying on Walt Disney World property, you can book your fast passes 60 days out. If you're staying off property, you can book your fast passes 30 days out. And if you book through me, you won't have to do your fast passes at all because I'll make all those reservations for you for free. Well, all right, that's going to do it for the first installment of the Walt Disney World Word of the Week. Thank you so much for listening, and I really hope you enjoyed it. And if you did enjoy it, I ask that you please share it with someone. Tell somebody about it. Like I always say, tell your mom, tell your brother, tell your sister, tell your dog. You probably know someone who's going on a trip to Walt Disney World, Disneyland, Disney Cruise Line really soon. Please just share this podcast with them. Let them know it exists. I'd really appreciate that. There will be a new Walt Disney World Word of the Week each and every Wednesday. I think it's easy to keep the W's all in line like that. And also look out for the regular episodes of the Ear to Their podcast that will come to you each and every Monday. So thanks again for listening. Have a great week. Bye-bye.